up your little game. We are the boys.
Welcome to our class assembly. In year 6,
we
have been learning all about World War II. At first, we thought the war started all because Hitler, the German Prime Minister at the time, invaded Poland. But we soon learned that there were many decisions that led up to Hitler's decision to invade Poland and the Allies' response. In year 6, we explored all the reasons behind this terrible war.
In order to understand World War I, we must first look at the differences between just World War I and World War I and II. After World War I ended, Germany was defeated. Brandon and Frank wanted to make sure war would not break out again.
That's right. They decided to put restrictions on Germany called the Treaty of Versailles. This was a punishment for Germany. It was a set of rules and restrictions Germany had to follow. It was signed on the 20th of June, 1919, exactly 5 years after the assassination of Archduke Ferdinand, which had directly led to World War I.
Time you're at the checkout, supermarket.
I'm rich, I'm rich. I can do anything I want. I'm rich beyond my
French did not react as aggressively as some people wanted, but decided that the Germans broke some of the rules and would not want another terrible war. This was known as appeasement.
We would have valued friends, we might tell them our suspicions, but the fall of leaf and land, let be sweet to them and day by day repeat to them.
Oh, it's hard work being Prime Minister of Great Britain, especially as the papers are full of scare stories about the new German Fuhrer.
Mr. Chamberlain, Mr. Chamberlain! Terrible news, sir! What is it? What is it? It's the Germans, sir. They've started building tanks, buying guns, ammunition, and other weapons, sir.
Oh, don't worry about that. They can have a few guns and bombs without causing anyone any harm. Get back to work.
Mr. Chamberlain, Mr. Chamberlain! Terrible news, sir!
What is it? What is it?
It's the Germans, sir. They've stopped paying the reparation payments. We've asked them nicely, but they won't give us another penny.
Oh, don't worry about that. We've taken over £6 billion from them since World War I. I'm sure we won't miss a few more pennies. Get back to work.
Mr. Chamberlain, Mr. Chamberlain! Awful news, sir!
What is it? What is it?
It's the Germans, sir. They've built up over 30,000 soldiers in the Rhineland to militarize them, sir.
Oh, don't worry about that. I'm sure they're only practicing. Or maybe it's just a big scout camp in the Rhineland. Get back to work.
We might tell them our condition, but the fall of Greece and then.
Life was about to change for the people of Europe and eventually people all around the world. When we learnt about World War II, we looked at the different places of war. These were the different places where the fighting took place. War started in Eastern Europe and soon spread west to France, Belgium, the Netherlands, and Norway. This was called the Western Front. Allied the forces of Britain, France, Russia, and the USA called the Axis forces of Germany, Italy, and Paris. Fighting also took place in the European Eastern Front, Pacific, Atlantic, Mediterranean, and North African fronts. This truly was a world war, with 50 million people lost their lives due to war-related diseases or famine, whilst 50 million people died due to fighting worldwide.
But life has been changing for the worse for some people before the war started. As part of the Nazis' push of power, they looked for an enemy they could present to the German people. British and French were obvious targets, but the Nazis needed a group of people who were closer to home to take the blame for the country's problems. These were the Jews.
During the 1920s and 30s, Jewish people who lived in Germany subjected to the campaign of Hitler's attack. They looked at the propaganda posters at that time and spread fear and lies about Jewish people. Hitler was able to turn people's anger at being poor and direct it against the German Jews whom he considered not to be real Germans. Jews were made to wear gold stars so they could be identified.
They were banned from using buses and shops that non-Jews used. Jewish children were taken out of regular schools and made to go to Jewish German schools. Jewish shops and businesses were boycotted. After time, Hitler ordered special camps to be created, and Jews were arrested and forced to go live and work in these labour camps in terrible conditions. Many other people who disagreed with Hitler or belonged to other minority groups were sent to these camps too. Some German Jews fled the country to try and find safety.
When the modern album is holding a triple stuff up, but the thing that worries me, that the whole dog family, is where we fall Largo in the blackout, where we fall Largo at night, he can't find his way.
Peter Todd, Albert and Frank. I'm German, and I also happen to be Jewish. Things have not been so good lately for the Jews in Germany. I've seen some terrible violence and hatred towards us. So much so, I decided to move my family to Amsterdam, in the Netherlands, to escape the Nazis.
That's right. My husband and I took our two young daughters, Margaret and Anne, to Amsterdam to start a new life in safety. My name is Ida.
I set up a new business, and things were going well. But in 1939, Germany invaded the Netherlands. The Nazis Trump forced Auschwitz concentration camps and made to do hard labor. I was separated from my wife and girls. I was the only person with the secret acts to start the war. I was liberated from Auschwitz by the Russians, and during my long journey back to the Netherlands, I learned that my wife Edith had died. Once in the Netherlands, I heard that Anna Margaret was no longer alive either.
And that was